Hello everybody, I'm Toby Loxton of TFL Creative Media and it's time. But what is it time for specifically? Well, the time has come for us to officially start production on TFL Creative Media's latest short film and my university dissertation production, The Railway Woman. The film that you guys have helped to finance and to make. During financing, we have done networking events, quizzes, celebration of International Women's Day and Autism Awareness Month, but all of your support and all of the hard work that the cast and crew have put in has led up to this very moment. Do you feel ready, Summer?
Very, 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 very ready.
Well, that is very descriptive.
I'm really looking forward to it. The time is finally here, so let's do it.
Yeah,
let's do it well.
Yeah, let's do it very well.
Yeah, my father's in agreement, so yeah. That's all the approval that we need.
Got a big stamp of approval there.
Okay, we're all settled in here in the room. We've got equipment scattered about all over the place in our Airbnb here. Going to the kitchen, and here's some of the crew. Say hi to the camera, folks.
Hi, guys.
Hello.
Got Lottie, Jessica, Charlie, Arthur, Maeve, Stephanie, and Angus.
Hey.
Hi.
Instead of announcing you bring the camera out,
I did bring it out.
Don't tell us.
Don't say I'm going
to. Oh, sorry, if I vlog, I need to make it spontaneous.
There's a camera there.
Oh my god, hide the body.
Well, you heard it from them. No, I can totally trust these guys. They won't let me down, I think.
You guys are joking about the body.
Now we're alone. I want to make it clear that I have got absolute faith in the people staying in this Airbnb, the people you just saw, and the people who are going to be coming tomorrow. But I would also like to make it clear that this is not like any production that I have done for TFL Creative Media. I mean, compared to things like A Clear Signal and Interpretations, which were done on very tight schedules with very limited resources, and it's metaphorically speaking, they were held together with bits of string. But not The Railway Woman. Not this one. Not with a large crew like this one and having a budget behind it. And yet, sure, I'm really excited to go out and film on a railway. But there is, conversely, so much on the line. It's not just, you know, keeping to schedule. It's about making sure that the people who are working on this production, essentially for me, that their time is not wasted.
All right, it's shooting day, the first day of shooting. It's 20 past 10, and already we are facing one issue after the other. For example, Angus, our cinematographer over here,
AKA. I don't know.
Well, we're getting him, him, Maeve, and Lottie as, for a 70s photograph as a prop, but those are the largest overalls that we had at a medium, and Angus doesn't quite fit.
No.
Yeah. Let's go over here and get photo quickly. Let them have some rehearsal time, and then I'll call you all in for a pre-showing, and then we should get into filming straight off that. Action!
Well done, Kevin. Well done.
If you can go and find a closet, you're welcome to wait in there for now.
Amazing as always, Sarah.
Thank you very much.
Train's coming in, so we're going to film the train.
But it also means that a scene that we're going to shoot at the end of the day is shooting earlier.
And that with a train?
Yeah. And that was
added train, which is not what we were expecting, so.
Yeah, and that's my fault. I decided to do that, so.
Blame Toby.
Yeah.
Okay, the time is now. Oh, it's just gone 10 past 11. The first day of shooting of The Railway Woman is now over, and it was certainly an eventful one. Also, it was a very long one. So now I'm going to get an early night. Well, we're all going to get an early night. And get up in good time and refreshed, ready for the next day of filming, the second day of filming, in Bognor Regis tomorrow morning.
It is Tuesday, second day, and I'm here with him. Harry Walters, how's it going, man?
It's going well, man, it's going well, yeah.
You're infused?
Am I what?
Infused.
Yes, I've had my cornflakes, I've had orange juice, listened to a bit of music, and I'm ready to crack on.
Charlie Sharp, aka Oliver, and Toto Squadron.
Hello.
So yeah, are you infused, Charlie?
Oh yeah, very excited. This feels properly professional now.
Professional?
Yeah.
What's that mean? Well, here we are in my flat, and our star is nearly ready.
Yes, nearly. She's just getting her hair done, which she loves so much.
like Harry and Charlie out there, are you infused?
Yes, definitely.
Good.
I am massively infused. I might not sound like it, but I am.
Yep, scene done. Was that beautiful? Beautiful. Mm-hmm. Thank you. Well done, Summer.
Thank you.
Fab job, Summer.
Do I need to
stick? This is a very big setup. Now we're going to get a move on to the next bit. Harry! Hey, Harry! Harry! Look at that! Look at this setup.
It's a wild Charlie Sharp.
It's a wild Charlie Sharp, you're right. In his natural environment. And now, it's your turn.
Are you okay?
What did you jump to? I'm not even
going to
lie.
Yeah, I just literally just jumped from out there in the garden where the fire is.
That's
just...
how it was so loud.
Hey, Maeve.
Yeah?
How do you think today went?
Well, it was an easy day, so it went really well for me.
It's a bit more complicated tomorrow, though.
Yeah. But you know what? I love a night shoot.
It will be a night shoot.
Yeah.
Ironically, just like this one.
Yes.
Yeah, so the night shoot went well, and the reason I'm wearing a mask inside our house is, well, first of all, I'm in Summer's room, just trying out the different outfit for tonight. Thank you very much for taking the time.
It's no problem at all.
I'll see you later.
See ya.
But the other reason that we are wearing masks in here, because we're using our Airbnb as a location. We're going to use the living room upstairs. Hello, Josie.
Hello.
Our brilliant, great supervisor. And be sitting on our wonderful set that we will use for one of these scenes. Like, upstairs living room, such a novel idea. And we are getting all the, moving around all the equipment up here. And everyone is very, very busy. But we'll be back up there real soon. Hello, just doing a bit of vlogging.
Okay.
How are you, Charlie?
Good.
Well done for earlier, Kevin, like I said, with earlier shoots. You feeling confident about tonight with the face acting?
Yeah, absolutely.
Ah, fantastic. When are we going to have the mask on? we're about to do a run through. How are you guys feeling?
Amazing.
Hi.
In the mood. Ready for a
knee
good on
you, sir. Alrighty-ho. This run through is starting to get overcrowded. Yeah, but this run through is starting to get overcrowded.
Yes, it's quite warm in here, remember guys, so let's get filming.
Yep, reset.
Okay, the fourth day has now gone past. We have wrapped quite a while ago today, but the call sheets have gone out for the final day tomorrow, and that final day, yeah, there's a lot happening because that is going to be the actual music number. So now it's around 10 past 12 in the morning. I should really get some sleep because it's going to be long and there's a lot of pressure. So let's get on with it.
Okay, so it's now the final day. And this is the day of the music number itself. As you can see, we've got Lily, our choreographer. All the cast are here today and they're just practicing. And I am super confident this is going to be so, so much fun. And cut! Amazing! Amazing! Thank you, Lily! Bye!
You're down for the final shot of the, for the final shot and scene of the day. Everyone has been amazing. But let's get this out of the bag, because I have had the I've got the privilege of doing the final cover board.
And hard for M board.
That's a wrap! Woo! It's a wrap!
Anything you want to say?
I want to go home and have a Chinese!
Well, I got that Chinese in the end. Is the day after Friday, which is Saturday, and that means that I have had an opportunity to recharge, recuperate after, quite frankly, an amazing 5 days. Sure, there were little bits where there were disagreements, little fights. Well, I wouldn't say fights, they're more little arguments. And also, I was really, my patience was tested more than ever before, and I knew that I did have to be more patient this time as director, but I didn't get angry, which was my biggest worry. But the thing is that with all this said and done, with all the success that I went through in the last 5 days, it has been absolutely amazing. And that wouldn't have been possible without the amazing cast and crew of people. Maeve Coffey, Lottie Morris, Angus Butcher, Stephanie Burley, Charlie Greenfield, Arthur Crisp, and Jessica Burgess, and many, many more, including the amazing talented cast with Summer Clark Graham, Kevin Cherry, Vince Shields, Charlie Sharp, and Harry Walters. All of them made The Railway Woman possible, and I'm absolutely grateful. Because there are times where we all go at each other's throats. It's quite natural for the film industry. But from every indication, there was definitely passion. And that passion showed that their hearts never ceased being that of true filmmakers. And we all enjoyed having this opportunity to make a film. Otherwise, I think we would either be working in a shop or drinking. But yeah. It was all down to them, and I'm so damn grateful for what they've done. Because the thing is, films are never made by one person. They're made by a whole bunch of people. And that bunch of people are so, so damn awesome.